Great to see you. Today's video is about quickly and easily creating DSTV NC data from multiple sources using the DSTV Assistant for SolidWorks. Here in our demo model we have step imports, SolidSteel parametric and also normal SolidWorks parts installed. This will rarely happen in the real world, but this way we can see it all in a single example. To start, simply click on Start DSTV Assistant, and the menu will immediately open on the left where we can define what we want to analyze. The selection is already set to analyze all, which we will do in a moment. However, we could also select individual assemblies or subassemblies or, with the lowest option, individual bodies. The fact that it says bodies and not parts is a deliberate choice because, for example, with SolidWorks multi-body parts, we want to identify the individual components. We go back to analyze all. Here at the bottom, under settings, we can make further adjustments. When we hover the mouse over the input field, we see the tooltip telling us. Select the resolution used when detecting profile geometry. Impacts performance. But what does that mean? Let's look at a single beam with some machining to illustrate this. The question is, which part of a beam is best suited to identify the profile? The start and end of a beam often have machined areas such as cuts, and there are often holes just behind them. As you can see from the cross sections, these points are not suitable for identifying the profile in this example. If the number in settings is set to 1, the profile will be inspected right in the middle. In this example, there is a hole, so the profile would not be identified. If we increase the value to 2, the profile will be split into 3 and scanned at 2 points, which in this example would have resulted in success in both cases. If we increase the value further to 3, the beam would be quartered and the cross sections shown would be recorded during the examinations. The DSTV assistant ignores the center and selects the most frequently occurring profile for analysis. Of course, increasing the number of sections to be analyzed will have a performance impact, but on modern computers you will only notice this if the assemblies being analyzed are very large. Okay, with that little excursion into theory, let's take a practical look at the existing assembly and see that there are no holes in the beam centers. We can leave the settings at the default of 1. The Analyze in Part Context option would ensure that solid body features are analyzed at the part level and not at the assembly level. We start by clicking on the green tick and the first step is an equal parts detection, followed by the analysis. Here we go. In the window that is now open we have the overview. When it opens, you can see several categories, solid steel parametric profiles, identified bodies and unidentified bodies. There is another category that is not available here, that would be solid steel parametric sheets, which of course are also identified directly by the DSTV assistant. The L profiles are listed for the solid steel parametric profiles. The equal part detection has recognized that both L profiles are identical. Therefore, they are listed only once and the quantity of 2 is noted for the NC data. In the identified solid bodies, we see U profiles, sheets and also I profiles that have been automatically identified. I expand the categories, then we also see the assigned part names. Then there are the unidentified solids, and here mainly all the screws are listed, which we can ignore. However, it also lists another plate and the rectangular tube that we want to export as well. To prepare the parts to be included in the DSTV NC data export, we right-click on the part and select Provide Information from the context menu. The DSTV assistant zooms in on the part and hides all other parts. On the left side we see a new menu and at the top we first define the component type for a plate, here marked with the letter B. In this context a short info. The DSTV NC format is used internationally, but originally comes from Germany. There, a plate is called a blech and is abbreviated accordingly with the letter B. Most of the abbreviations are intuitive, but a few things have to be memorized somehow. We will make an info PDF about this. You will then find the link in the video description. Let's continue. After selecting the type, we see a small sketch showing us how to select the alignments. Edges or faces are available for selection, but with the sheets there is a special case where you only have to select the top face and the X and Y axis will be defined automatically. From this view, you can see that the axes in the 3D window match those in the sketch and all dimensions have also been automatically recognized. We can simply confirm this and a new category user-defined information has now been added to the overview, which contains the now fully defined plate. Okay, now let's prepare the rectangular tube for the NC export. The procedure is exactly the same as before. First, right-click and select Provide Information. Then the component is zoomed in again and all other parts are hidden. We set the profile type to M for rectangular tube. Here we don't know why it is an M in German either. It should actually be marked with an R there too. If you know why this is the case, please post it in the comments. Now we define the axes as shown in the sketch. Unlike with the sheet metal, we now really have to specify the X and Y axes here. I use faces for this, then the normal vector of the face is always used for the direction. So here is this face for the X axis, and this face here is a reference for the Y axis. We can see in the preview that the axes are now aligned as in the sketch. The dimensions have also been transferred correctly again, we can confirm. This completes the preparations, and the two initially unidentified profiles are now listed under user-defined information. I'll stop the video at this point to show another typical case and the solution. The rectangular tube was not in the database, and I have to admit that I deliberately drew the dimensions and shapes so that this would happen. This is the cross-section of the tube as it is in the assembly. Neither the dimensions nor the shape conform to any standard. The rectangular tubes are normally formed sections and therefore have radii at the corners, which the DSTV Assistant uses to detect profiles among other things. Another criterion for recognizing profiles is of course the dimensions and material thicknesses that we can add to the database. Adding the dimensions to the database will not lead to automatic recognition of the beam as long as there are no radii at the corners, but will automatically fill in the information provided in the database when you add the beam manually. We can open the database via the preferences and edit it by clicking on Edit. To display only the rectangular tubes, we filter on the type M and I then filter further on the German designation QRO with a height/width of 200. As we can see, there is no entry with a material thickness of 20 millimeters. We click on Add to create a new profile. Here we enter the country code for standard, the M for beam type, give it a name, enter the dimensions in meters, and to complete it we also enter the weight per meter length, confirm with OK and save the database. We already know the rest of the steps. I will show both NC data later so we can see the differences. Let's pick up where we left off. If we want to export DSTV NC files, we can export individual components by right-clicking on the component and selecting Export from the context menu. If we want to export only a specific profile type, we do it in the same way by right-clicking on the iProfiles, for example. So this works for every entry here in the overview. We want to export everything and therefore right-click on the main assembly at the top here and select Export All. A menu opens again on the left, where we see the selection overview at the top, which is just a list of all the components that will be exported, and we cannot change anything here. In the settings, we first enter the order number, which does not have to consist of numbers only but can also be a text. Under File Extension, we can choose to save as an NC or NC1 file, depending on which file format our machines work with. The options here under Export Blocks are convenient. Here we can select which machining operations will be written to the NC file. You can look up the names of the blocks in a list, but explanatory tooltips are also displayed if you hover over the options with the mouse. For example, if there are labels on the components that should not be included in the NC file, we could uncheck the SI option here, where SI stands for signatures. The file path for saving is specified at the bottom. This one is fine for me, but of course you can easily change it here. We are ready for the export and confirm. This takes a few seconds. You can tell that the export is complete when the icons are no longer grayed out. Let's have a look at the result. A new folder with the name specified and order number has been created in the selected folder. This folder contains another folder with a timestamp. This way you can keep track of multiple exports with the same order number. As expected, the folder contains the DSTV NC files of the exported components. We will first open the rectangular tube as text to see what the NC file looks like. The code is relatively unspectacular. Only the tube is defined as there are no other operations. But let's compare the code with beam info added to the database on the left with the one without on the right. They are identical to line 13, where line 13 is the quantity, by the way. They differ in lines 14 and 22, which means that the name of the profile and the weight per meter are missing. This is not a big difference, but especially a missing profile name in line 14 can cause machines to refuse to work, so it is best to provide all available information in the NC data. When we open the file in a viewer, we see the interpretation of the NC data as a 3D model. Okay, now an eye profile with bores for comparison, first as text. Here we can see, for example, the additional code block with the holes, and now we will also look at the file in the viewer. There it is, and here we can see the whole beam including the holes. And of course the same process worked for the plates as well. Here we see one of the plates including the holes. As you have seen, working with the DSTV Assistant is easy, and the path to finish DSTV NC files is fast regardless of the source of the templates. The software can do even more if you define your machine park with various parameters such as tools, speeds, tool life, etc. in it. The machine parameters plus material costs can then be used, for example, to automatically generate a cost estimate for components. But that's a topic for another video. Instead, if you would like to see how to create perfect templates for the DSTV Assistant using SolidSteel parametric, take a look at the suggested video here. See you next time, and thanks for watching.